Now, may I request Dr. Ramesh Ralia to give his presentation to us?
Sure, thank you. So, all can see my screen. Can one of them confirm?
Oh, yes, sir. Yes. So,
thank you. Respected Dr. Victor, Dr. Cherian, and Dr. Sridharanji, all members of UPASHI, our state marketing manager, Sri Manikananji, and SMM Tamil Nadu is also joined, Sri Jayaraji, and our marketing chief marketing manager, Sri Rajnish Pandeji from head office, and all the respected members who joined this webinar to discuss. So I will give a brief talk in addition to what Rajnish Pandeji has mentioned in his talk about nano urea. And then during my talk, I will also address some of the concern raised by the respected speakers at the initial regarding the trials and the future collaborations and some other related to efficacy, mode of actions, toxicity, safety, etc. All. So I will address those questions while going through. Meanwhile, I also request all the attendees that if they have question, they can also put in the chat box so that after the talk, we can go one by one. So today, respected friends, again, good morning. I'm going to talk about nano fertilizer, specifically nano urea. It's in liquid form and it is developed using nanotechnology. So most of you may know like what is nanotechnology, because at the as the name described, nano means very small, ultra small. And how small it is, like if we talk about one nanometer is 1 billionth of the meter. So how this creation of such small particles help increase nutrient use efficiency or help in fertilizer or bringing benefits in agrochemicals and fertilizers, we will discuss here. So if we talk, because today we are talking specifically about this nitrogen. So if we talk about nitrogen, as earlier mentioned in by one of the speaker that the nitrogen content in the tea leaves is around 3%. 3 to 4%. So similarly, if we talk about all the plants, all the agricultural crops, on an average, the nitrogen percentage is about 1.5%. Although some plants has higher, some plants has less, it varies from 1 to 5%. As in the tea, it is about 3%, 3 to 4.5%, and then it is potassium, calcium, and other nutrients. So certainly that the nitrogen is an important nutrient element for the crop. Why it is important, that also mentioned earlier, that it is an structural element of protein, carbohydrate, chlorophyll, amino acids, and genetic material. If we talk specifically about the chlorophyll, I would like to mention here chlorophyll and carbohydrate and protein, three things here, because tea leaves are mostly like green part, and the greenness of the leaves is determined by the chlorophyll pigments, and specifically chlorophyll A, B, A. These colors are determined by the nitrogen content available in the leaves. And when the adequate amount of chlorophyll content is there and plant do the photosynthesis process, there will be an adequate amount of carbohydrate that basically determine the biomass of our leaves. Or the productivity that determine directly and indirectly the productivity. And then the nutritional quality comes in form of like whether it is amino acids or the protein content as a whole. So all these three factors are quite important in the tea where we harvest the leaves, as in leaves are the target harvest for us. Because as you rightly pointed out earlier, that in the other crops, we may not look for the leaves for the target, because there might be grains, there might be roots like that. If we talk about like wheat or pearl millets or other crops. So if we talk about nitrogen supply today, the majority of the nutrients that we are applying to the plants more than 82% of the fertilizer that what we are using for the crops, it is through the urea, granular urea. And this bag, you may recognize it's about granular urea conventionally that we all are using for our crops. But the challenges with this urea is whatever we are applying to our crops, the use efficiency, the nitrogen use efficiency or nutrient use efficiency is only about 30 to 40%. Where the remaining goes, because when we apply this urea, it has to be taken up by the crops efficiently. If the crop is not taking it up, then it converts into different form of chemicals. Like for example, NOx. We all heard about the NOx in the from the pollution perspective, that what is the NOx content in the air, nitrous oxide content. Then the ammonia emissions in the air that cause the air pollution. Similarly, in the soil, if we apply more amount of urea, granular urea, it causes the acidification of our soil. And as you know that when the soil pH gets changed, then in that case, plant do not uptake the other essential nutrients in the adequate amount from the soil. And because most of the nutrients plant uptake is directly or indirectly influenced by the soil pH. And then if we apply urea in excess amount, it can convert in the nitrate form and leach to our groundwater or through the during the watering or during the rain, it can leach out and reach to our freshwater bodies and cause the nitrate pollution. And that is called eutrophication, where the nitrogen and phosphorus content increased in the water, which caused the algal bloom and all that water-related issues. So to address these concerns, IFCO has established a nanobiotechnology research center at Gandhinagar, Gujarat, in its mother unit, where we develop different type of nanomaterial-based research for the future sustainability and the precision agriculture. And one of them is our invention, which on which we all are talking today, is about nanourea. This nano urea is developed to provide the nitrogen and as an alternative of conventional urea that we are doing as a broadcast. There are huge losses because of the broadcast and very less uptake by the plants. That's why we developed this nanoscale particles. In these particles, we encapsulate the nitrogen form of nanoparticles, and they are coated with organic polymer. And when we apply these particles on the plants through the foliar application, the plant uptake these particles efficiently and then utilized it. I will come on that slide in the next. So just to compare the particles, that why the nano matters, why this nanoscale like really have importance. So let's compare that. On one side, you see the conventional granular urea. On another side, you see the electron microscopic image of nanourea. The particle size of conventional urea is about 1 to 3 millimeter, whereas the nanoparticles is about, like average size is about 30 to nanometer. And the particle sizes ranges from 20 to 50 nanometer on an average. But the range and the average size is 32. So if we calculate the surface area, by volume size mass ratio. Let's say 1 gram of conventional urea, 1 gram of nanourea. Then the number of particles is way high. How much in terms of engineering that one particle of nanourea, one particles of conventional urea equivalent to 55,000 particles of nanourea, at least if they are like at our lowest limit of the particle size. And if we calculate that surface area, the surface area is over 10,000 times. And why this surface area worked? Because you just imagine for a moment that it just worked like a vaccine, intravenous vaccine to the crop. That because when there is a more surface area, then it find more opportunity to interact with the plant cell metabolites or the component inside the plant cell. And thereby even the applying very small quantity of the nutrient, it basically fulfills the plant's nitrogen requirement. We are applying these nutrients through various applications, both through drone applications and the conventional applications. Conventional application is, as you can see, that farmers spraying this nano urea on wheat. On other side, we are also promoting and using drones to spray the particles on the crop. The benefit of drone is if we can spray on tough terrains like in the hilly areas and on the crops which are bigger in size. And also the other benefits are coming that it requires lesser amount of water and it can do rapid spray, like in 5 to 6 minutes it can cover an acre area to spray. So the recommendation above is one spray and second spray 30 days and 2-3 weeks before flowering. Certainly this is for the conventional crops like wheat that is shown in the figure. But for the tea, because I have learned that in the tea, you are applying about 20 bags a hectare. So that way the doses application. So the dosage application, we have to, in a general sense, we have made that what you apply through a bag of urea, like which is about 45 kg. So you apply one bag of urea or you apply one bottle of nano urea by foliar spray. You will get the same plant response in terms of yield, in terms of quality, in terms of plant growth and development. In fact, once you apply, you will see that in the other crops, on an average, we have seen that it increased the crop yield by 8%. But since here the biomass will be calculated through the leaves, so I'm expecting even higher yield by applying the nano urea. But for that, whatever you are applying at the basal, because this is a perennial crops, the question was that perennial crop. So we have done some trials on mango in West Bengal. We have done some trial on apple in Jammu and Kashmir and in Himachal Pradesh as well. So we have done the trial on perennial crops, but a very limited trial on tea, I think. So we are starting the tea trial with all of you. The question is how much to apply. Then I would say that you apply the rate, that number of bags equal to number of bottles. And then whatever, if you are applying anything at the basal, at the initial planting stage, maybe like DAP, MAP, anything at the basal, do not cut that. Whatever the urea you are applying, you can replace one bag by the one bottle. At the initial, I would recommend, because there is no enough amount number of trials on the tea, so I would say that you reduce the conventional urea by 50%. Let's say you are applying 20 bags a hectare, if I have the correct number with me, 20 bags a hectare, then reduce by 10 bags and apply the 10 bottles and then see the impact. And then once you have the better experience over the period of time, then you can gradually replace the company. So at least in the initial, I would request you to like replace by 50% and then you can start, because we have the learnings from all other crops that we can replace up to 50%. Next is uptake. When we apply through foliar applications, as we all know that our plants have stomata on the leaf surface, there are very small pores. And if we see that these pores are available both on the lower epidermis and upper epidermis of the plant. When we apply these nanoscale particles, these are very small in size. And when these particles land on the plant leaf surface, there are three mechanisms to get it uptake by the plant. One is direct penetration, another is uptake by the stomata, and third is there are a small structure that is called hydrothorns on the leaf surface. So these particles can be uptake through all three mechanisms. Once these particles are uptake by the plants, then these particles can be translocated from one part to another part of the plant. that is like source to sink. Wherever the new plant required like more nitrogen content, it reaches to there through simplest translocation mechanism or phloem translocation mechanism. Phloem translocation mechanism is same as what the plant do this photosynthate. When plant do the photosynthesis, there is a carbohydrate formation, and that carbohydrate basically, as a result of the plant photosynthesis, this carbohydrate translocate from one part of the plant to another part of the plant, up to the roots, even through the root exudate. It also secretes some sugars and amino acids and like that. So the on that the same mechanism, these nanoparticles can be translocated by the plants, by the plant cells. We have tested these this nano urea on more than 94 crops across India. These are some of the photographs of different vegetables, different crops, both like vegetable crops, horticulture crops, long duration, short duration crops like that. Yeah, and the another benefit of this nano urea, when I mentioned that a bag of urea can replace by this nano urea, then it is like easy to carry, easy to store, easy to transport and ship also. So those are the benefits. Before bringing this to Indian farmers for common farmers to use, we have tested this product on 94 crops at more than 11,000 locations, including we have partnered with more than 20 institutes of Indian Council of Agriculture Research, state agricultural universities, and Krishi Vigyan Kendras. And as I mentioned earlier, we have found on an average that it increased the productivity by 8%. It includes all the crops like cereals, legumes, leafy vegetables, other vegetables like that. But in case of the tea, because we are going to directly harvest the leaves just like the leafy vegetables, so at least personally I'm expecting little higher productivity than the number mentioned here, the 8. And it help, this particular product help in reduce the use of conventional urea and the environmental pollution out of that. From the safety and toxicity perspective, there was a question and comment I received in advance that because the tea is directly, leaves are directly consumed and we spray on the crops. So this is the similar case of leafy vegetables. Like we spray, we harvest and we eat. In case of tea, at least we process it either before drinking the tea or before we are making it enable to drink the tea, or even we put in the boiled water to extract the essence and then we drink. But leafy vegetables, we directly spray and we eat. Sometimes we eat without any processing, like as a salad. So we have tested these products. Of course, we have not done this on the tea leaf, but we have done on more model plant where the chance of consumption for the human is more higher, like leafy vegetables, spinach and lettuce. We spray nanoparticles of nano urea on the lettuce and the spinach at the recommended dose, and then we made these leafy vegetables to eat by or consume by various model organisms defined for safety and toxicity test. And we have found that the product nano urea is completely safe. It does not cause any harm that you spray on the crop, and if you eat or consume that part of the crop, that is not going to harm because of nano urea. We have done safety and toxicity. What are the all the tests we have done? It is as per the Department of Biotechnology, Government of India guideline. So Government of India in 2020 has launched a guideline for evaluation of any products related to agriculture and the food products based on nanotechnology. There is a certain guideline, and the guideline recommends the number of tests on safety and toxicity, and that includes microorganism and earthworms of soil, then environmental organisms like pollinators and all that, and water, how it pollutes the water, how it is affecting the fish and other aquatic organisms, and then of course to the plant itself. And then once the plant is consumed, directly or indirectly. When I say indirectly, means like we spray on the leaf and consume the grain, or spray on the leaf, consume the roots in case of like beetroots and so. Or if we consume on the plant leaf and consume the leaf directly as a raw or as a process. So all these the permutation combination of toxicity and safety trials guidelines are given in this DBT guideline, and we have tested as per that. And after all the testing, the reports were evaluated by the DBT, Department of Biotechnology, and the Indian Council of Agriculture Research. And after that complete evaluation, the government of India gave the permission by gazette publication in the Gazette of India, and included this nano urea in the fertilizer control order. So if we talk about like in holistically about nano urea, it required less compared to conventional urea. It enhanced the crop productivity. It is economically affordable when we compare with conventional urea, which we get, farmers get at 240 rupees, but that includes the government subsidy, so it also economically affordable. Even with the subsidy, it is 10% cheaper, but if you include the subsidy, then it's much more cheaper. And then safe and sustainable for food and environment, and it is non-toxic for flora and fauna. In the flora and fauna, I have mentioned like various organisms here. It starts from fish to Daphnia to chicken to mice, and then pollinators, then human who is spraying itself, and several microorganisms. Because at the farm level, not only the farmers, but there are like several biodiversity related flora and fauna that are associated. So in summary, this nano urea is a revolutionary product developed by nanotechnology to provide nitrogen and enhance the use efficiency to spray. If we spray with the conventional sprayer, then mix with 2 to 4 ml per liter of water and spray on the crop. So the average recommendation comes that one bottle is for 1 acre. So if you are spraying through the drone, then you have to go by the bottle, like let's say like one bottle in and 1 acre. But if you are spraying through a conventional sprayer, then the doses will be 2 to 4 ml in a liter, and about in an acre, about 90 to 120 liter of water is required to spray. So these doses have to be in mind. Keep in mind that the mode of application. If you are spraying through drone, if you are spraying through drone, one bottle, 1 acre. If you are spraying through the conventional sprayer, then the 2 to 4 ml in 1 liter, and then spray on the crop. We have tested this on 94 crops and over 11,000 locations, farmers field locations, including ICR, State Agriculture University, and Karsivik and Kendraj. This was also tested in your state, like in Kerala, in your neighboring states. Also, we tested at Kerala Agricultural University also, I think, and also at Tamil Nadu Agricultural University. And this is one of the first nano fertilizer approved by Government of India. And this is tested on the basis of national and international guideline. When I say the international guideline, in the national, I mentioned the DBT guidelines. But in international, there is a guideline to test nanomaterials is related to OECD guideline, Organization of Economic Cooperation and Development, that guideline. Based on that guideline, we have tested this product safety, toxicity, and usefulness for the environmental sustainability and precision agriculture. One question left related to the mixing with other nutrients or other water-soluble fertilizers, other pesticides, herbicides. So in general, I would say that when you do any kind of mixing of any chemicals, any agrochemicals, when you mix two salt solutions, or then it is recommended to do a jar test. What is jar test? Jar test means when you mix two chemicals, then either and mix two chemicals and keep it for 5 to 10 minutes, then you will see if there is a precipitation, or if there is a flocculation, or if there is a settling. If you see any kind of that, then it means that you cannot mix those two chemicals. But if that is not, then you can mix those chemicals and spray. That is like chemical compatibility, a visible indication at the farmer's level. At the nano scale compatibility, we have tested this product with several agrochemicals, and we found that you can mix and spray. You should not mix and keep it overnight or keep it for 5 hours and 10 hours, but you can mix and spray quickly, that you can do that. Regarding the one of the question was there that by adding the more nitrogen, there is a chance or more nitrogen through foliar application, there is a chance of pest attacks. So in case of, because I don't have the data directly with me about the pest attraction or insect pest attraction on tea, but I do have the data related to the on various crop, various vegetable crops, flowering crops, that when you apply this nano urea, there will be a minimum, even the reduction in the insect and pest, because one of the organic polymer that we are using along with this is basically shows an antimicrobial. So even when you apply this nano urea, there will be a minimum insect and pest attack. Like there is a nutrition, of course, this is a nutrition, so nutritional benefits are primary, but there won't be any insect pest attraction in addition through the foliar application of this nano urea. And then I have answered the question which I have received earlier. Then there was a question related to the future collaboration with UPASI Research Institute or Research Center related to the trials of nano DAP and nano copper. I would suggest that we also have nano zinc also. So even you apply the zinc, because you know that most of our soils are getting deficient with the zinc. So I would also like to add one more element, the nano zinc, and we can provide you an adequate amount to do the trials on the tea or coffee and rubber plants there. So I would request you can coordinate with our state marketing manager in Kerala and Tamil Nadu respectively, the place, the whatever the nearby and convenient to you, and we can provide these for samples to you for testing. If you would like to visit our research center, you can do visit us for more collaborations and other things that you would like to do at Gandhinagar, Gujarat, and we can also visit your place to see more and explore more opportunities so that we can give the precision and sustainable solutions to our tea grower farmers, rubber and coffee grower farmers. With that, I would also like to mention one thing, that IFFCO has dedicatedly developed a website, nanourea.in, www.nanourea.in, because this is a new product. So there are like a lot of questions, concerns, and there are knowledge gaps. Still, although our marketing team is making huge efforts to educate, to communicate the new technology and about this new product, but still there are like a lot of concerned questions, both from the farming community, from scientific community, and from the general public also. So we have developed this website, www.nanourea.in, where you can see like all the details we have put up there, including some educational videos also we have put there. So you please go through that. I recommend that. And still, if you have questions, we would be happy to answer that. With that, I would like to thank you and would be happy to take some questions.
Yeah. Thank you, Dr. Ramesh Ralia, for an elaborate and enlightening presentation to all of us. Now, we have put all the questions that have come up from the audience in a PPT form. So maybe I would request our host to display it on the screen so that we can go one by one.
Sure.
Yes.
Can you go on slide one and then large it? Okay. Compatible. So should I start?
Please.
Okay.
Yes.
So the first question is related to the compatibility with often used pesticides. As I mentioned in my talk, yes, you can mix it, but do the jar test, please, because that's a general recommendation, because there are like a lot of different combinations are coming. So in so like to avoid any kind of wastage, like at least do jar test with about 0.5 liter, 1 liter, or about 100 ml solution. And jar test is very simple, that basically you take two glasses, just like our tea glass or water glass, like that. You mix two chemicals at the recommended doses, keep it for 10 minutes. If you see any kind of precipitation or settle down, then don't mix it. If you do not see any kind of precipitation or settle down, then they are okay to mix and spray. But for any chemicals you are mixing, my recommendation is do not mix and store, mix and spray directly. And when mix at the recommended doses, do not mix at the stock concentration. The next question, if my answer is not complete or adequate,
I like to add, Dr. Sir, I think there are 16 insecticides and pesticides which has already been tested and found to be compatible. The list can be provided by Mr. Manikandan. And the next thing is, when we are adding into the tank, so you have to mix it in the water separately, then you add the water, the diluted water together. So this is going to be reduce the impact of that.
Does it affect the efficacy of the pesticide?
Not at all.
Okay, thank you.
Still, like while responding, if anyone had a supplementary question to my response, may write in the chat box. Next, I'm taking the next question. Any study on the residual activity of nano urea application in tea? No, so far all these answers, my answers may not be based on the tea, but based on the experience of the other crops. That is the reservation I'm telling. So any residual activity of nano urea application in tea, we have not found any kind of residual activity. We have done even like application. So once you apply and like this part, once these particles are absorbed by the plant, it acts as a just as a nitrogen nutrient for the crops. So there is no residual. Even in the there are two plants. On one you spread the conventional urea, on another you spread the nano urea through foliar application. You won't see any difference in terms of residual accumulation in the plant leaf. But what you will see that you might find more protein content, more fiber contents, more carbohydrate contents, and beneficial nutrients that you might see in the nano urea. That's what my experience is on various leafy vegetables, because I'm comparing this plant as the leafy vegetables from the residual accumulation perspective. Then the question is, without nano potash, how do we spray as combination? So we can
use Dr. SOP in this, sulfate of potash, which is a water soluble.
So because as at present IFCO do not have this nano potash in the market for the commercial uses, so the recommended another source of potash can be used with that. Whether nano urea is cleared for use in agriculture by Environment Ministry? Yes. To use any product for agricultural application, the permission is given by the Ministry of Agriculture. To set up the manufacturing plant, permission is given by Environment Ministry. So we have received the environment clearance from the Environment Ministry to set up the manufacturing plant. We have received the permission from Ministry of Agriculture, that is called Central Fertilizer Committee, and Ministry of Agriculture's recommendation through which it included in fertilizer control order. So we do have the essential permission, and it is cleared by the Government of India after the necessary review of trial, multi-location, multi-crop trials at different agroclimatic conditions.
MOP is not compatible.
Sorry?
MOP, muriate of potash.
Muriate of potash, sir, you will apply it through the basal dose and you will apply the nano urea through the foliar application. So that's why we have said the SOP you can mix up and you can apply it on the foliar part. So if the leaves are young and the plant is very young, you can apply the basal doses. But when you are applying it afterward, so you can use the source as a water soluble source of water, this potash. So for adding it along with the spraying it along with the nano urea,
what ratio we can use?
The SOP is used as a the percentage. It is the SOP is the dosage. The dosage is 10 to 15 gram per liter of water, and the nano
with the nano urea.
Yeah, and the nano will remain as the 4 gram per liter.
Four ml per liter.
SOP
4 ml. Sorry, 4 ml per liter.
SOP 14 grams.
Yeah, 10 to 15 grams.
10 to 15.
Then the
Sir, excuse me.
Yes, please.
Go sir, ahead. Currently we are using MOP 2 kilo and 2 kilo urea in 200 liters of water. So how do we proceed with this? Whether nano urea can replace this urea and it can it go with the MOPs?
Are you diluting? MOP cannot be diluted. No? You are applying it to the basal dose.
Now, current recommendation is 2 kg urea and 2 kg MOP in 200 liters of water and applied through foliage.
Okay. Applied through the foliage.
Foliage, yes. Foliar application, sir.
You are doing it a foliar application?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. So then I think when you are doing a foliar application for MOP also.
Okay.
So then SOP and MOP both you can utilize otherwise. If you are using the foliar application for MOP also.
Now, can nano urea go with MOP? I'm just asking, sir. I would like to have clarification.
That we have to test it. But SOPs anytime a better option because the chloride content is very less. It is less than even 1.5%. So always any source of nitrogen, as any source of nutrient which is having a very less source of less content of chloride, is beneficial to our plants.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Yeah. I request all the participants to put forward their questions in the chat box so that we can take up one by one. So because Dr. Ramesh Rale is started to answer one by one all the questions that has been already raised. Thank you.
That is next question related to is nano urea compatible with DAP, which is we use 3 kgs to 4 kgs in 250 liters of water and water on tea as foliar. I would request here that when you use this DAP through foliar application, yes, you can use nano urea. You can mix with that. But if you are using this DAP, I would suggest to test our nano DAP as a trial. And you will see the very good impact compared to this conventional DAP that you are displaying here. But you can mix it there. That's not a problem. But I don't think so. DAP is 100% soluble. There are like some sediments must be there. So after you first you disperse the DAP in the water. And then if there is any sediment, just remove that sediment. And in the upper supernatant part, you mix the nano urea. And that is very well compatible and mix it. But I would request that please try with our nano DAP part here for this to replace this 3 kg to 4 kg DAP, which you are applying on the tea. What happens when potash is given as soil applications, nano urea spread, will it be a mismatch? Because nano urea, we are not recommending to mix in the soil. The reason is the aim of designing of this product is to increase the use efficiency and minimizing the nitrogen losses to the environment. So that's why we are doing the foliar spray here and not putting in the soil, because as soon as we put into the soil, soil is the complex system. It has a lot of other minerals and nutrients, and this material make the complex. And again, they can change their size, morphology, and different form of chemical. So they reduce the use efficiency of the nutrient. So if you apply through the potash through the soil and apply nano urea through foliar application, it is not a mismatch. You can do that very well. But as suggested in the earlier, that SOP, you can mix with nano urea and spray both together. What is the recommended dose for nano urea in tea? We have some of us using 100 ml per hectare to 500 ml per hectare and 1.2 liters per hectare in 300 liters of water. So I would say that the recommended dose of nano urea, if you are spraying through the conventional sprayer, like backpack sprayer, then 2 to 4 ml per liter. 2 to 4 ml of nano urea and 1 liter of water and spray on the crops. How many times? The whatever times you give the urea splits, the same number of times you have to provide the nano urea. You can reduce the conventional urea by 50%. If you are spraying through the drone, drone spray, or using the drone if you are spraying, then you require less amount of water. And then at that time, you have to go buy a bottle for an acre, one bottle for an acre. Separate application of urea alone will increase the sucking pest. Can it be added with MOP or SOP for foliar application to reduce the ill effects of nitrogen? First of all, by using nano urea, I don't have the direct data from the tea, as I mentioned earlier, but I have the data from other crops that when you will apply nano urea, it will not attract any additional sucking pest on your crop. And it can certainly mix with SOP and spray on the crop along with that. I mean, you won't see any ill impacts. The reason is, the first thing is the total N content, total nitrogen content is less here. The second thing, whatever the N contents are here, they are encapsulated by N biopolymer. So it won't affect your, it won't provide nitrogen to any leafy, on the leaf surface eaters or sucking pests like that. These particles will be uptake by the plants and released in a controlled manner. Is nano urea recommended for spraying on soil? No, it is not recommended to spray on the soil. Based on nitrate reductase inference, can nano urea liquid along with potash can be ingested at the right time of secretion when it is active for 2 hours that often synchronizes with sunshine hours? Yes, it can be mixed together and spray on the crops during the sunshine time. That is fine. If I understand the question correctly, if I understand this question, that can we mix these two and spray on the crops? Yes, you can mix and spray on the crops, and because it is not going into the soil, so there is no impact of nitrate reductase. So how many hours or days does it take for nano urea to be fully absorbed by the plants, and how long will it remain in the plants? In other words, that should be the interval between applications. Yes, there should be an interval of about 15 days because once you apply, because that's the main feature of this product, that once you apply this nutrient to the plants, it will sustain and control release the nitrogen to the plants. So it will constantly keep providing the nitrogen without losing, because if you apply the conventional urea, plant just taken up completely, like in 4 to 7 days and 4 to 8 days, depends on the urea's activity in the soil and all. But in case of nano urea, it provides sustained release of nitrogen. Once you apply, it is more than enough for 10 to 15 days.
But how long does it take to absorb, be fully absorbed by the plant?
Yeah, so typically it takes like 1 to 4 hours, depends on the age of the leaves. Because as the plant leaf grows, the cellulose content, hemicellulose content changes in the cell wall. So typically it gets absorbed within 4 hours by the plants.
Can I ask one question?
Yes, please.
Nitrate reductase often gives you the correct indication when it is likely to absorb.
Yes.
During that period, once if you are able to ingest through the drip irrigation, will it solve the issue?
Sir, because again, that will be through the soil. So this nano urea is currently the product coming in the market is not suitable for mixing in the soil or through the root zone application. Because when it goes into the soil, like again, the efficacy, it will be, the efficacy will be better than the conventional urea, but it is not as desired. So that's why we are recommending through the foliar application.
I have understood that. The point is, once if you are able to understand this nitrate reductase, when it goes up to the peak after the 10th day, and after the 14th day when it starts coming down, again, we give a small dose that maintains the equilibrium of the tea plant completely. So how do we go about this? This can be done partially by spraying and partially by giving ingestion through drip.
Yes, that can be done, sir, through the splitting. I mean, like the conventional urea can be given through the drip.
Yes.
And the remaining you can give through the foliar spray of nano urea.
So this may sort out many of the issues.
Yes.
And probably after pruning, when the plant is deprived of the foliage, this may be a right objective.
Yes. Yes, that can be attended, sir. Thank you for that question.
Thank you.
Do we need 12 hours of rain-free weather for absorption of nano urea? Yes, it is recommended that if the rain is within 12 hours of spray, then it is recommended to do the repeat spray of the nano urea. What is the absorption rate from the time one apply the nano urea? The absorption of the number of particles that we applied on the plant leaf, like about 86% that we have absorbed in that laboratory level, we have tracked these particles uptake efficiency is about 86% of the particles get absorbed within 4 hours. Would like to know exactly how nano urea replaced large quantity of N as applied by the ground application. Understand that efficiency in soil is less. The efficiency of soil application and so the balance will be utilized when application. Okay, so the overall the question is how the large quantity can be replaced by the small quantity. So when we use nanotechnology or nanoscale materials, the concentration not only applied as mass concentration, but the concentration also applied as a concept of surface area concentration. So the surface area concentration is 10,000 times higher than the conventional urea. So that basically overcomes the requirement of mass requirement of the conventional urea in this case. So even if you apply very small quantity, it replaces that. It is just like, if I give you a simple example, it's just like the, like if we eat a chocolate, it basically has very small quantity in mass, but it has the more amount of energy. Like a small bite of chocolate might have like 200 calorie, whereas if we eat like 2 kg of salad, it is still won't reach at 200 calorie. Like so it is like working as a concept of that, like surface area to volume size ratio. Then the question is, how successful are drone spray for nano urea? Cost per hectare of spray, any good firms who have advanced very much of drone spray? If the SMM Tamil Nadu is here, I would request him to unmute and tell about some example which we have done in Tamil Nadu Agriculture University. If not, then Rajneesh ji.
Yes. Yes.
Okay. Jairaji, can you give some example related to drone spray which we have done in Tamil Nadu Agriculture University?
Yes, sir. Actually, we have done in maize and paddy, sir. In paddy, actually, 1 acre we have taken for this capacity of the drone is 10 liter. That means one bottle we used. Suppose the drone capacity is 16 liter, we used for 1.5 bottle for 1.5 acre. So actually our recommendation is 1 bottle for 1 spray per acre. So depend upon the drone volume we used. Then the difference is compared to normal spray and drone spray. The droplet size, because of micro droplet, the penetration is very, very fast. The response is very nice compared to the our hand spray. Not only in Tamil Nadu Agriculture University, we have field spray done in Trichy area, Perambalur and Sugarcane area, in maize in Tuticorin district. So many places we demonstrate in the presence of district collector and joint director of agriculture department. So many people involved. The result was very, very positive and more response from drone spray compared to hand spray. Because of the reason is two things. One is because of micro droplet, easy penetration. And another thing is because of this drone, some wind is somewhat opening the leaves, covering the all the leaves at a time to get all droplet wetting. So it is final output, total result received from DNA in the form of result also. It is in documented result received from DNA for paddy. It is very, very positive. Then another one more question, it is requested by some of the one person. It is MOP mixing with the urea. Nowadays, MOP is costly, around 1,700 rupees. Our chief manager, Rajnish Pandey, when he is during his presentation, he mentioned the seaweed extract, Sagarika liquid. It contains 14% to 18% potash. But some of the tea estate already using in Valparai. For example, Moody's and some of the estate regularly buying Sagarika liquid, that is seaweed extract for potash compensation. When you come to the nano urea combined with the Sagarika liquid, in so we have done so many places in field crops, not in the tea crops, but in the field crops of sugarcane, paddy and maize. The combination is very much compatible and the result was very much encouraging. The thing is that we should not mix with the separate tank. Spray tank suddenly we have to spray immediately. We should not allow to settle the liquid for long time. Normally, farmer used to prepare the solution and keep in one side, and each tank they will spray. That should not be happen. We have to mix in the spray tank only, not in the separately. Because of within half an hour, 1 hour, we have to complete the spray. It is what our Tamil Nadu Agriculture University Nanoscience Department also advised us. It is compatible with the nano urea to other spray solution, but in quick action, within half an hour to 1 hour, we have to complete the spraying operation. If we allow for the solution is allowing for 3 hours, 4 hours, means nano particles will be joined to one and another. So nano particles become the macro particles. That is the instruction given by TNA. But if our field spray also we have done within half an hour or 1 hour. That is, I think, the result is encouraging.
I'd like to add into this. Sorry.
Can I come in, please?
Yeah, please, sir.
It is, I'm giving you an open invitation. I'm prepared to work with you on nitrate reductate principles in my estate if you are willing to cooperate with me onto this. It's an open invitation.
Sure, sure. Thanks a lot, sir. Thank you, sir. I was adding just a point to the drone part. The costing part has been asked. So I'd like to add to that, that we have, IFCO has come up with the, we have started one scheme for that also. Across India, what we are running is a entrepreneur Viman scheme. Under this, a basic drone costs around 3.5 lakh rupees. And one battery of it is around 4 lakh. So total is 50,000. One battery is 50,000. So total is 4 lakh. Additional, let us say, 4 more batteries if we add, a pair of batteries. So that is 2 lakhs. So total cost is 6 lakhs. So 6 lakh, under 6 lakh, you can cover more than 5 to 6 hours of spraying altogether without any break. So let us, a 10% of the cost, you have to identify some of the young entrepreneurs who can cover your tea states or your some of your off-roll employees who can be a part of this. So they can, for them it can be done. Like they have to invest 60,000, a 10% cost of 6 lakh. Rest 5 lakh, 40,000 they can get. We will arrange to provide them an agri-infra fund. Government of India has started just agri-infra fund at a 4% cost, at a 4% of interest. So 5,40,000 can be taken from there. 60,000 is their only investment. Then after that, when they will start spraying, so let us say almost 150 days of total spray period. We have taken 200 days of spray period. Out of 365, if 200 days they are spraying and for 30 acres they are covering a day, for tea states they can cover easily. So what we have come up with, they can earn a very good margin, like around 60 to 70,000 rupees a month. Because if we keep, even we keep a per day, a per acre cost is 200 to 300 rupees, means coverage cost. So they can earn 60 to 70,000 rupees per month. So this is a model which has been created. And under this, we are enrolling many our farmers or the young entrepreneurs from the rural areas, and we invite our members from UPASI also. They can also come up with this and can provide drone to them.
Mr. Pandey, could you let us know what drone with this 3.5 lakhs that you're talking about?
Yeah.
Would it be possible to let us have details of drone, and also what are the licensing? Because I understand the government of India talked about some changes in spraying.
So yes.
If you have some details made out to UPASI, and UPASI could circulate to us, please.
There are three zones they have developed. This is red, orange, and green zone. So for the green zone, it is coming up with the without any license. Just within December, I think, the new guideline is going to come up, in which there will be no license for the green zone. So this meeting is there within Agriculture Department and Niti Aayog everywhere. So very soon this guideline will come for the green zone, and for the very basic, they will decide the heights also. For this height and for the green zone, there will not be any license. And for that, very soon, in 10 to 15 days, this guideline will come, and that I will circulate to you.
Along with details of that 3.5 lakh drone, who are the suppliers, etc.
Yeah, that also I will provide.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
So, sorry, I went for a second for attending phone call. There is a question about what is the particle size of normal urea? Am I on the right question? Excuse me. Any study on the nano urea on worker safety? So that is the first question.
From the second one.
Sir. Oh, the slide is changed, right? Administrator, can you please mention?
From the yeah, please. Dr. Ramesh, you can start from the second question.
Okay. Will the application of nano urea...
I think you didn't answer the question on worker safety.
Yeah, I'm coming from the top.
Okay, sir.
So will the application of how successful the drone spray of nano urea cost per hectare of for spraying? I think that question was answered earlier through Rajnish Pandeji. Will the application of nano urea through drip irrigation be more effective than foliar? No, the foliar will be more better than that drip irrigation. So we recommend through the foliar application. Is this technology is patented by IFCO and approved under FCO? What are the steps for prevent spurious material in the market? Is there any analytical methodology available to quantify the nitrogen content in nano urea? Yes, it is through the FCO, fertilizer control order. This product is approved by fertilizer control order. The product manufacturing process is patented by IFCO. That is yes. The steps to analyze the nitrogen content in nano urea. Yes, that is like very simple, there is a TKN method, the total gel-dal nitrogen method through which we can analyze the nitrogen content in this, the same method which we use for conventional urea. So the nitrogen content analysis can be done through the same process. Regarding the spurious material, so far we have not received any such kind of complaint or things like that. But if you find anything like that, you may inform to our marketing team locally in your state or to our office at the head office.
To add into this, I like to add, we have made a very stringent guidelines, and very stringently we are covering it up. Like even the bottle of this nano urea, we are making in our this plant. In our Kalol plant, even you will not find this bottle outside anywhere. We are making the material with which this bottle has been made. This has also been imported, and shape and size, it has been also been made in this plant only. Nowhere else it has been made. The cover which you will find on this is also been embroidered into it. Means it is not outside. It has gone inside. And then it is having a QR code, all details are there on it. So it is very difficult to copy it, and even if will somebody copy, so there are some guidelines for that also.
The used bottles may be taken back to avoid all these things.
For that also will come up, sir.
You may think about it.
Mm-hmm. Sir,
they can be taken back. Huh?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay.
When we go in for another purchase, this has to be returned.
That should be returned.
Yes.
Oh, this is a good idea.
That's good suggestion. Yeah, thank you. The question is, what is the particle size of normal urea after dissolving in water? When we dissolve the conventional urea, it converts into the ions. Even the size would be the even smaller, I would say, like even at the ionic stage. So we have to understand the difference, the size at nanoscale, that's an stable size. When you talk about ionic liquid, let's say like any nitrate or sulfate, or even the conventional urea, you put into the water, their size will go at the ionic level. That is an angstrom scale. So the angstrom scale, the particles are at the unstable stage. So that is the difference between the ionic liquid and the nanoparticle liquid. And the ions are, again, these ions are not showing the stability in terms of material stability when we apply on the crop, whereas when we do these nanoparticles spray, they do show the impact on that. Then another difference related to the phase, I would like to show there is a one difference in the phase. So when we make that is in the simple chemistry, there is a definition called true solution and colloidal suspension. So when we make the ionic solution, that become like true solutions, like our sodium chloride, like our sucrose solutions, and they don't scatter the light. But at the physics and chemistry, I'm explaining this. The another, in case of nanoparticles, it's a colloidal suspension. And the colloidal suspension means it's a two-phase system. One is solid phase, that's your nanoparticles. Then it's the colloidal micelle, that which are like suspended in the liquids. So that is what the difference between the ionic liquid as well as nanoparticle suspended in the water. Can you please make it full screen? Yeah. Why can't nanourea replace normal urea by 100%? Yes, it can replace, but because this is a new product, and that's why at the laboratory scale, at the research level, we have done those trials that how it can replace the 100% conventional urea, but we are not recommending to our farmers at large, because if something goes wrong or if they don't follow the, because for that you have to increase a little bit of the concentration and application, and you can 100% replace the normal urea by applying one bottle equals to one bag of urea. But certainly at this moment, at the initial early stage, this is first year of our commercial launch, so that we are recommending that 50% replacement. And that is also a very huge number if we look at the nation at large. Will nano urea play the role of carrier for MOP that is supplied in normal granular form as it is available now? We have not tested this, but certainly you can mix in the water and spray together, but we are not sure, and we have not tested from the carrier perspective that whether it will play the role as a carrier or not. We have used nanourea extensively. The results are satisfactory. Thank you for that, Mr. Arsu.
I'll request Mr. Arsu, can you speak please for 2 minutes? It will be a first-hand experience for everyone, you have done it on tea. So it will be really grateful if you can speak for 2 minutes about your experience.
Yes. Can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Good morning to you all.
Thanks. Good morning, sir.
Good morning to you all. Due to the acute shortage of urea, we were looking at other possibilities and we came across this idea. And it was very difficult to get the nanourea to start with. So we tried our level best, even sent people to Coimbatore to get a few bottles of nanourea and used it in our tea fields, conventional area. The results are quite encouraging as far as I have seen it, to the tune of 12% yield increase was there. In my opinion, it was not done scientifically. It is not done randomized. I've also noticed that there are no sucking pest incidents further. Normally, we don't have any sucking pest incidents in this estate where we have used it. Quite happy. Only thing, what I had a discussion with your team of people, they suggested that it can never replace the soil application. But what I heard from you all, is that it can probably replace the soil application. If it is so, it will be very good, but I don't know really. Anyway, I think it's a very good product, and I'm happy to say that, yes, it is a good product. It works. Thanks.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Yeah, next question is, thank you, Arshuji, for your sharing your experience. What are the ideal weather conditions for nano urea spray, considering that we have heavy rains, cold weather, and dry months? Except the rainy days, you can spray the nano urea on any day.
Dr. Ramesh just wanted to check up. While we understand that you need a 12-hour rain-free period, is there any limiting temperature? Because the dry weather temperatures go up, you know, in the tea plantations to 26, 28, 30 degrees. So does urea efficacy, is it going to destabilize because of high temperatures? That is what we wanted to know.
No, it will not affect. Up to 50 degrees centigrade, you know, like we, like this nano urea being utilized in Jaisalmer of Rajasthan, where in summer the temperature goes to 48 degrees centigrade too, on pearl millet crops.
So it is not related to the growing phase of the plant.
So of course,
phase of the plant.
Yeah, it's growing phase of the plant is important for other crops where we have tested, but like the temperature is not the important. Like at whatever the temperature you can apply it, the only thing, the certain uptake rate may get differences from the different temperature to different temperature. As if the temperature is very high, extremely temperature is extremely high, then the stomata of the plant leaves get closed.
So what is the soil moisture content required?
Sir, soil moisture content is independent to that, because again, the soil moisture will impact the stomata and that may affect the uptake efficiency. But that is because the uptake efficiency is not only dependent on the stomata, but is also through the other mechanisms. So if it is severely drought, then like it is not recommended to spray at that time. First, it is recommended to give the water to the plant and then to spray.
Thank you, sir.
Sir, what about the minimum temperature for the impact of nano urea?
Sir, it is temperature independent. We have tested in the plant growth chamber in the controlled condition from 4 degrees centigrade to 48 degrees centigrade to do some climatic study. So it is not going to affect. Only the effect comes in terms of uptake efficiency at different temperature. Plant closes their stomata. So that influences little bit of uptake efficiency. Otherwise, once the nanomaterial is impact uptake by the plant, it's not going to affect it by the temperature.
Sir, another one important question, sir. Sir, because here in South India, the pestability is a major problem in South India, all over the deep growing areas. So can we mix with the copper
oxychloride? Problem?
Can we mix with the copper oxychloride along with the nanomaterial?
Copper hydroxide, you are saying?
Copper oxychloride.
I think you can mix it I think you can mix at the recommended doses. Certainly you can mix it. But I would suggest that you use our nano copper just for the test or just for your first trial or second trial. And you just see the impact where like your doses requirement is very, very less. And it is highly compatible with that.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Yep. Will it reduce the abiotic stress during dry months, please?
Sir, we have seen that right before application of the stress, whether it is osmotic stress or drought stress, it increases the lipid peroxidase activity in the plant cell membrane. And because of that, it certainly gives plant benefit in terms of sustaining the stress, whether it is like we have tested on different stresses, like salt stress, like temperature stress and the water stress, and we have found benefits, but we are not claiming as of now because we are validating with more factors on that, including like what kind of impacts are coming on different heat shock proteins, specifically for the temperature.
But Dr. Ramesh, this is contrary to what you just said 5 minutes back.
What?
You said that the stomata opening and closing will decide the efficacy of that. Now, when we talk about abiotic stress,
yes,
going into dry weather,
yes,
and if stomata closes,
yes,
it will not have any effect. So how can it affect any parameter of the plant?
Sir, I say that when the plant closes the stomata, like So the particles are uptake by the plants through three different mechanisms: direct penetration, through hydathodes, and through the stomata. So if one door closed, two doors are still open.
Yes.
Right. And then the stomata opening and closing dip. It is not that stomata closed for entire 24 hours. There is an stomata closing when the temperature is very high. And then the stomata closing also depends on stomata closed at the upper epidermis of the leaf or lower epidermis of the leaves. So like there are like several factors depends on that. Because the distribution of stomata on the plant leaf is vary by the crop type and also the climatic condition in which the crop is being grown.
Got that. Thank you very much.
Right. I think we'll be able to do a wonderful job when we ingest through drip during the dry months along with the spray of nano.
Sir, we can do that for that trial, but because for the recommendation perspective, I'm not recommending this because when we put these nanoparticles through the soil.
No, I'm not saying through the soil. We spray nano as a foliar application and balance
urea through drip.
Through drip.
Yes, absolutely. That will work the best, sir.
That will work wonders.
Yes, sir.
Right, thank you.
That will work well, sir.
Yeah, thank you.
Then there is question related to what is the production capacity of nano urea as of now and it is going to be scaled up? Yeah, IFFCO currently has the capacity of producing about 1.5 lakh bottles per day at its mother plant Clol, and because the demands is very high from the country and also from other countries, so that's why like IFFCO is making its efforts to scale up in the times to come.
Like to add into this, like IFFCO is going to come up in at least 7 plants just by 2023, and it will present capacity of around 3.5 crores bottle. So we'll scale up it up to around 40 crore bottles and annually. So there will not be an issue of availability.
Then question is there any possibility of getting approval for use in the organic garden? Any study on nano urea? Okay, organic garden. So we do not have the organic certification for this product, but we know that like some of our customers are using in their organic farm, particularly for wheat and horticulture crops, but we do not have the organic certification for this product as of now. But related to the residue accumulation, that is one of the parameter in organic certification. You won't see any kind of a residue accumulation because of application of nano urea.
I like to add into this, like there is one Krishi Vigyan Kendra at Rewari. So he has started his trials almost 2 years before, and he has started with the complete area of around 25 acres, and at present he is doing the trial in 110 acres. So the main issue was him. He's doing an organic farming. So main issue was him was the availability of nitrogen organically. So he has found the result in this nitrogen nano urea, because he is using biofertilizers and our Sagarika, and now a nano urea. He has got this nano nitrogen source through nano urea, and he is producing it in 110 acres. And all these farmers are getting very good output, and they are selling directly to the Delhi market and getting good results.
Mr. Pandey, that's very surprising, because he cannot be certified organic if he's using nano urea. If you say organic dictionary meaning, that's fine. But then
dictionary meaning, obviously, nitrogen, if you want to get it through organically, so there is very difficult. So farmers who are getting a really problem. So that's why he has added nano urea into that, though it is not certified, but he is getting very, very good result. Dr. Anil Singh is the KVK scientist, and he is doing this trials. Not even trials, not this. It is going to the market also.
Question is related to next question is, any study on worker safety? Is it okay to spray the nanoparticles? Yes, at the recommended doses, it is safe, but we recommend users to use the gloves and mask while spraying any kind of agrochemicals for whether it is pesticides, herbicides, or any kind of agrochemicals, we suggest to use mask and gloves along with this nano urea. Although we have done the safety and toxicity test from the DBT guide, as per DBT guideline, and the product is safe. Can we mix microbes along with nano urea? Like, it is not recommended to mix microbes with nano urea, because it depends on, because if then I have to ask you the species of the microbes and then test on the microbial compatibility. So if you have any specific application out of that, you please send the small microbial strain along with MSDS so that we can test the compatibility and let you know. But as a general recommendation, I won't recommend to mixing microbes with nano urea. Will spraying nano urea during days with high temperature will result in salt concentration? You can apply with high temperature days, but recommend that little early times, like 9 to 11 a.m., 9 to 12 a.m., and then not at the peak hours, peak temperature hours, but besides the peak temperature hours, you can spray the nano urea on the crop. Any other next slide, please, if any? Okay, that's all. Any other question, please? Any other new questions out of that what we have discussed other than that?
Only one question I wanted to ask you.
Yes, sir.
N15 label study is the proof of assimilations. Can we able to do study of nano urea N15 study, so that it is 100% proof that it will be useful? We have 80% of the crop is tea, harvested in high cropping tea. So the demand is very high. During the time, will it supply or not, we don't know. Am I right?
Hello, sir, can you repeat your last part of the question, please?
The N15 label study is first for recommending tea.
Yes.
Nano urea. You are supposed to do nano urea in N15 label. If you study it, then only it will be useful for us, the assimilation part. So how much urea is converted into ammonia to form, that is amino acid or something. Am I right?
Yes. So the question related to N14 and N15 studies related to the uptake. So that study, we have done the common uptake studies in terms of yield, in terms of nitrogen use efficiency by the crops, but we have not done the study related to the radio labeled N15 and N14 on that.
Then one more question. You have put it for dicyanamide to evaporation crops. Cyanamide is mixed with
your nano urea. No, we don't use cyanamide in nano urea development.
Sir, this is Dr. Rajkumar.
Our source is not the cyanamide. Yes, please.
Sir, this is Dr. Rajkumar from Utpa City RF. Actually, I have done some preliminary analysis for nano urea for nitrogen analysis. So I have found that total nitrogen content is around 4%, which is confirmed. But when I going for the available nitrogen, it comes below 2%. So it will be any impact on the plant leaf under it, sir?
So
Available is coming below 2%. I have checked two to three times actually.
Like how did you test that available?
Geldal method.
Through Geldal methods. So through Geldal method, how much nitrogen you are receiving?
For total nitrogen, I have received around 4 actually. 3.8 something I have received.
Through the Geldal?
Yes, through the Geldal.
Okay.
When going for the available nitrogen, so without digestion.
That's a good question. So what happened? So that is we call like sustained release mechanism. So in case of urea, let's say like you take the urea granule, put into the water, the entire nitrogen will be available for the plants to uptake. That is we call burst release. Whereas in case of nano, it is in sustained release. It's in controlled release. So the total nitrogen will be available to the plants in a controlled manner. Like up to 14 days, you will see the 100% release of that.
So in your opinion, Dr. Ramesh, should we be looking at available nitrogen or total nitrogen when we analyze?
So when you analyze, you have to look for the total TKN analysis. total nitrogen.
And that would apply for soil analysis also?
Sorry?
Would that total apply to soil analysis also?
No, this is applied through the foliar application, right?
Okay, fine.
Thank you.
Dr. Ramesh, I'll just introduce myself. I'm Bhupender Singh from Parry Agro. We have used nano urea in our season last year in Assam gardens, and we have found very good results. The only thing is because there was no dosage which was available or no confirmed dosage which was available for tea, we went with a basic thumb rule. And thumb rule is that 0.5 liter of nano urea replaces 45 kgs of urea bag. So we were applying 4 kgs, that is 1% of urea concentration, that is 4 kgs in 400 liters. And I converted that into 50 ml of nano urea per hectare. That's the dose which I used. And we found excellent result. Now, as you very rightly said, that, you know, tea is still an unexplored territory. And where the doses which are recommended, there are people who have sprayed up to 400 ml and they have not received the benefits. But whereas I received the positive benefit at 50 ml per hectare also. So, because I use a principle, simple thumb rule. And the only concept which, why I used that was, because tea is a continuous harvesting crop. Unlike the other crop where we are using higher concentration of nano urea, where the foliage is retained on the bush or on the plant. Like wheat and all that, foliage is not harvested. But as far as tea is concerned, every 7 days in Assam, every 7 days we harvest the foliage. So the smaller concentration at a repeated dose, at a multiple doses are required.
Yes.
So we used about 7-8 rounds of nano urea at 50 ml and we found a fabulous result. So I think both Upasi and probably TRA at in Assam, Tokla in Assam, will have to do much more intensive studies. But definitely it is a fabulous product. I vouch for it. No pest infestation and fabulous the growth what we have received, the growth what we have achieved and all that is, it was very good. So this is one small experience from Assam what I can share.
Thanks a lot, sir.
Thank you, Mr. Bhupender. I would request my state team to visit and make that field demonstrate for other farmers as and when required.
Yeah, I've used for entire 600 hectares. I've used about 7-8 rounds for 600 hectares. And but only thing is, you know, it becomes very contradictory. The only concept or only thinking which goes in my mind is because rest of the crop what we are looking at, it is they are a perennial crop where the leaves are not harvested. Here in tea, because every 7 day we harvest a leaf, a smaller dosage at a regular interval will definitely help us in a much better way. That is what I achieved. I mean, I'm again saying that I'm a planter, I'm not a scientist. So, you know, necessity is the mother of invention. So there was no urea available. So we started that and we came to this particular thing. So I welcome the entire IFCO team. Entire IFCO team to visit Parry Agro Garden in Assam and we can take it forward. We are willing to do further studies and further experiments on this.
Thank Great. Bhupender, did you also keep a control plot?
Hi, RK sir.
Hi, how are you, Bhupender?
All well, all well.
I'm saying, also keep a control plot?
Yeah, we did. We did.
Oh, good. So, what was the percentage increase on that?
The percentage increase what we noticed was about 10 to 12%.
Oh, wow. That's great going.
That's great. That's great.
That's wonderful.
Thank you, Bhupender ji, for sharing the experience. I would request my SMM to follow up and then we would like to visit the place.
But my only humble request with whatever small experience we have from last year, that the high dosage of nano urea for tea, this thing, like something like 200, 300 ml or 400 ml, what we are talking at, because if you see on a bottle, it is given 2 to 4 ml.
Mm-hmm.
Because we apply multiple doses, multiple repeat doses, I think there is a need to review the dosage of nano urea for tea.
Yes, yes.
Because in a month, at least every 15 days interval, we keep spraying because it's a foliage crop. So whatever you have sprayed, you remove it after every 7 days or 8 days in Assam and probably after 15 days or 20 days in South India.
How many sprays, sir, you have done?
I have done about 8 rounds, six to eight rounds.
Eight rounds, let us say.
How do you report your ground application?
No, sir. Ground application, what I have an initial information on the nano fertilizers is that it should not be applied on the ground because it gets bound by the other chemicals or other salts which are available. So we did not apply nano urea on the ground. We used only for a foliar application.
What about normal urea? Have you applied in the ground?
Normal urea, since the availability was not there post May, June, in Assam we apply only two rounds, mainly 2 to 3 rounds of urea because the cropping period is very short. So we could apply only first round of urea, and after that we have not applied. So once we could not get the ground application, we continued with the foliar application of nano.
So 8 rounds of nano urea with 50 ml yeah. for an acre.
50 ml per a hectare, 2.5
per hectare. Okay.
Yeah. No, see again, Pandaji, the simple principle was you saying 45 kg replace 500 ml replaces 45 kg.
So in that way.
Okay. Mera 45 kg is what I use. 45 kg I use for 10 hectares. So okay. I divided 500 ml by 10 hectares and I used that dose. I mean, that was a absolute, kya bolen, chaat buddhi.
What was the spray volume per hectare? And is it mixed with any other?
400 ml, for 400 liters.
And any zinc, boron, manganese or anything added, or only pure nano urea?
No. The micronutrients were there. Along the only thing, the urea got replaced by the nano urea. The conventional urea got replaced by nano urea.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah, one last issue, please. I have worked on nitrate reductase principles. I'll be too glad to collaborate with you on that, with my experience, with whatever little experience I have had on that. I have worked for the past 12 years of it.
Thank you, sir. We are open to collaborate with all the scientists and farmers. And we thank you, the farmers who share like experience, like Bhupender Singh Devraji. We are really encouraged by the feedback, and we will certainly work on further improvement of the doses as you suggested, and would like to learn more about your trial as well. And we are happy. IFCO is, as all of you know, that it's a farmers organization. It farmers own organization. So we are here to collaborate with all of you, to work with you and to optimize the doses based on your crop's need. And you have, because I am a scientist, but I'm also a son of farmers. My parents are farmers in Rajasthan. So I feel that farmers are the best scientists because they give the real feedback that what the crop respond every day. So that's why what is your observations are based on that. We are here to tune in our product, doses, further studies and exploration. And then various past research experience like Narayanji has mentioned about the nitrate reductase and the different abiotic, biotic stresses. We are here to explore those opportunities as well in the future and time to come. And if you have any more question, comments, suggestions, your experiences, you can share to our SMM, you can share to us directly as well at nbrc@ifco.in. And we are here to help you. And those who would like to take a trial for our nano DAP, nano zinc and nano copper, may please send an email or contact to our SMM, Monica Nanji, and those from Tamil Nadu with Jairaji and nearby area. We are here to help you with like all possible ways.
Yeah. Dr. Ramesh, my name is Surendra Mohan.
Hello.
Yeah, I would like to add a few things. It's an excellent presentation. We learned a lot.
Thank you, sir.
But replacement of ground application of urea by foliar, I don't know. I have my own reservations. Second thing is that we are only talking about application of foliar. Now, I would like to throw a challenge. I'll give you a field, very high yielding fields with only machine harvesting throughout the year, no hand plucking in between. Now, we would like to sort of work out a schedule where exactly it will fit in with micronutrients and all that. I hope Dr. Victor Ilango is listening to me. So, Dr. Ilango, can you take it up with them? I think we'll have to look into the future as well. Now, I would like to throw my fields open and let's work out a schedule which is applicable to machine harvesting for very high yielding fields. When I said high yielding fields, the nitrogen could be 400 kilos per hectare per year. Now, how are you going to replace it with foliar? I don't know. It's anybody's guess. So let's work together and find a solution for it.
Sure, sir. We will work with you. Currently, we are just saying about the 50% replacement. Our recommendation is just 50% replacement of what is being broadcasted, the conventional urea. But as you suggested, we are here to work with you, with your field. And we will request our SMM to coordinate with you and plan the schedule of...
I'll send a mail to you soon, very soon.
Absolutely.
Thank you, Dr. Ramesh.
Absolutely. So thank you all. And if you have any more question, do let us know by email or anything. We are here to help and work with all of you.
Thank you, Dr. Ramesh Ralia. Now, may I request Mr. Manikandan and the state marketing manager to give the vote of thanks, please.
Good afternoon, everyone. Last 2 hours, we discussed about the nano urea, and we have learned a lot. For arranging this webinar, Dr. Victor sir, I give a thanks to him because Dr. Kumaragur from Wayanad, he started while discussing we have to start with some program for the estates growers. Then Kumaraguru sir told that we will do the program. Then we discussed with Victor sir. He arranged the program very nice manner on behalf of IFCO and myself. Thanks to director sir. For the inaugural address given by Cherian sir. Thank you very much, sir. Sridharan sir, Chairman T Committee Uppasi. Thank you very much, sir, for the participation. The chief guest, Mr. Ramesh Ralia, he gave an excellent presentation on this nano urea. He spared valuable time with us. Thank you very much, sir. And our marketing director, Mr. Yohendra Kumar, sir, and Rajneesh Pandey, and all the Uppasi TRF centers, and all the estates people. Thank you for your participation. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot, sir. Thanks for sparing so much time.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Also, great initiative by Uppasi.
Yeah, this is a very great initiative, and we like to get collaborated in future for specifically all range of all our nano urea, then Sagarika, and all range of our soluble fertilizers, so that we can serve in a better way.
Already given the samples, we received the samples of nano DAP, and we are supplying through Uppas. In this season, we'll start the trials.
Okay.
Along with the nano urea, Sagarika, and DAP, these we will try. We will do the trials.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Namaskar.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you.
Namaskar.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, everybody. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.